And we are back. This time for the top four match between Kenny Lee and Farman. And with me, since Isaac had to withdraw due to a pretty bad sore throat, I have someone who fell in the top eight, Justin Lok, who tried to fly the Zygarde flag and flew it pretty strongly, but went down 2-0 to Melvin K in the top eight game.
It was pretty bad, as in for me. But Melvin played very well, I would say. All his mons are just too bulky for me to break.
Zygarde not packing the requisite power to break through Melvin's sturdy mons.
Alright then. But that's the past. Let's not dwell on that. Next up, the match that we have is Farman versus Kenny. Kenny, an old face here that we've seen many
Kenny
times.
Kenny running a somewhat standard-looking team with the Xerneas and the Kangaskhan and Groudon, I believe. Farman's team, a bit different. I lost Farman actually previously on the stream, so
yeah.
But not quite as wacky as the typical Farman team.
So. Yeah, I expected him to run. When I look at the usage test, there were 10 smellers. I expected Farman to be one of the 10.
But surprise, surprise.
Yeah, he wasn't. I actually fought him in Swiss as well.
I beat him, I believe.
Yeah, I beat him. There was some hacks, I believe. Rock Slide, misses, and whatnot. Eh.
He's packing the Mega Salamence, one of the few players bringing that as their Mega this time. Yeah. And he's protecting it with, I believe, a strong array of support mons. I believe he has the Among Us with the Rage Powder.
Yeah, and he has the... Instead of the Crobat to set up Tailwind, he has the Whimsicott instead. I believe the Whimsicott runs Encore as well.
Encore,
yeah, instead
Encore,
of the Taunt.
Yep.
So, in this matchup...
Two Xerneas and... Kara against the Groudon, so... Farman perhaps packing the advantage with his Primal. Assuming he can control the weather. Since, well... If Whimsicott does carry Worry Seed, then...
That would be worrying. Yeah, that would be worrying.
Very funny.
I had to. But at the same time, Farman, I believe... He... is more incentivized to try to get the Xerneas to geomancy.
Among Us, in fact. Among Us on both sides. So Among Us starting to make a resurgence in the VGC16 metagame despite
Isaac,
not dealing that well with the Primals and with Quasar.
Isaac, you lied.
So Kenny, perhaps... Kenny's trick room option is definitely there with the Cresselia. Though Farman does have the on-call with the Whimsicott to discourage that. Especially if he can lock Cresselia in with his Mega Gengar.
I think the key here will be the Whimsicott. It being Prankster means he can outspeed the Crobat, try to lock down some of Kenny's mons before.
In fact, I believe if Farman does go for the Whimsicott and Gengar lead, there's not that much Kenny can do to
prevent Fake Tears Shadow Ball,
Fake Tears attack combination. Especially with most of Kenny's mons looking pretty slow other than the Crobat. And even the Crobat cannot outspeed the
Whimsicott. Yeah, because Fake Tears would be priority. Yeah, but I think Kenny's key to victory here will be somehow getting the Xerneas to set up Geomancy.
So again, you can't Geomancy in front of the Whimsicott because of the Encore.
Yeah.
So we go right into the game. Farman versus Kenny. So we're about to see what both players bring in. Probably no Primals from both sides to begin the game. As Megalovania is the Gengar. Yep, the Whimsicott
like...
start, as I perhaps did call previously, since
it
gives him very strong options against Kenny. Kenny leads with the Kangaskhan Cresselia. And if Kangaskhan does not carry Scrappy, this could go south pretty quickly.
But he could fake out the Whimsicott to ensure that the Crest would survive. Shadow Ball, I don't think, was enough to kill the Crest.
But then at the same time, if he fakes it out and Gengar Mega evolves, he's going to be locked into the fake out next turn.
Yeah, I was actually going to say that Crest could deny the speed control, the speed that Farman has by Trick Rooming. But that will change if he Trick Room and Mega Gengar evolve. Yeah.
But I suppose if Kenny does have the Mental Herb, then that would be solved, since it would negate the taunt.
At the same time, Farman can just easily, I think, go for a Fake Tears Shadow Ball to kill the Crest.
Kenny probably forced to fake out the Whimsicott here. Unless he's Scrappy, then he'll want to fake out the Gengar.
Yeah, so right now it's forced on Farman to try to get some momentum on his side. Not really seen...
Well, Kenny might actually want to switch, since I don't think either of these mods wants to be trapped in front of Gengar Whimsicott. And this is his last chance to switch before Mega evolves.
These two have not fought before, I believe. So, well, this could be a...
Kenny does walk into the Mega Gengar. So...
Let's see if the Kangaskhan goes to the sucker punch.
Yeah.
Oh, he Mega evolves as well. So no Scrappy fake out.
Either fake out on the Whimsicott, or making a hard beat and going for the sucker punch on the Gengar.
Sucker Punch would be
able. No fake out.
Comes
on through the Cresselia, and Shadow Ball will be enough to take it down with the -2 special defense.
Yeah, and
Mega Gengar's huge special attack stat.
No Sucker Punch, as you stated from Kenny.
So, Kangaskhan probably going to attack into the Whimsicott since he has
double H.
Double H won't take the Whimsicott out, even through a Tadlit Sash. Well, it doesn't even go to Sash anyway. We just got packing a fair amount of bulk. So the Kangaskhan now trapped in Mega Form with only Sucker Punch as an option to hit Gengar. And well, I believe Farman does have, well, probably doesn't want to bring the Salamence in, since he can't Mega the Salamence now. Although Intimidate will go a long way against the Kangaskhan.
Yeah, but at the same time, since he's being locked down by Sucker Punch, what options does Farm have to dodge the Sucker Punch from the Kangaskhan? Does he have Waste or Disable? Mm.
Disable
would be the would be the most optimal here.
Oh, the Xerneas coming out from Farman. And Kenny bringing out his Groudon. So a very strong option, able to Precipice Blades and KO the Gengar and do massive damage to the Xerneas.
Yeah, but at the same time, I kind of expect Farman to, if he has Kyogre at the back, to be able to switch out into the Gengar slot, one denying the Sucker Punch from Kangaskhan, at the same time also changing the weather to match beat Kenny's ones.
I'm not sure if Farman really wants to be taking the Precipice Blades for free on this Kyogre, since it is the key to him winning this matchup.
Indeed, and Xerneas also a bit.
If he predicts the attacks onto the Gengar, I believe the Gengar Protect and perhaps the Geomancy from Xerneas would be the call here.
But a double into the Xerneas will also be very, yes, very dangerous.
But Kenny, not sure that Kenny really must be making that play.
Yeah, at this point, I don't think Farman can risk losing any mons. Otherwise, the weather would be in Kenny's favor once he manages, if he manages to break the Gengar lock.
Farman going through his options pretty carefully.
Yeah, I do expect Kenny to try to double into the Xerneas because that would be the most threatening.
Oh, Disable does come out, but no Sucker Punch coming out from the Kangaskhan. So, Xerneas the double edge. So Xerneas is going to get a Geomancy out for free!
Oh, now that you think about it, even if the Disable on the Kangaskhan was a pretty smart move.
Even the Kangaskhan would disable Sucker Punch.
Yeah, exactly.
Free up the Gengar for the rest of the game. Though now Precipice Blade is probably going to take out the Gengar.
Yeah, I think that's a risk that...
And Kenny can switch out his Kangaskhan now.
Not more importantly, he can switch out the Groudon now.
Oh, see, Precipice Blades misses the Gengar. All this is irrelevant.
Oh, Xerneas avoids Xerneas.
Farman will take that. Losing his Gengar, Gengar's done his job, taken down to Cresselia, but he'll take that miss on Xerneas.
Yeah, at this point, Kenny's free to switch. I believe switching out Groudon will be
He's
more...
He's gonna need to make a choice. Yeah. Does he want the weather or does he want the Kangaskhan with double edge?
I do believe the weather is more important considering that Farm has brought his Primal Kyogre to the field.
Oh, I believe Kenny's gonna hope that the one at the back is Among Us because nothing else is gonna enjoy Origin Pulse switching.
Well,
if it's not even Origin Pulse, or I suppose we want Origin Pulse in case you eat a Sucker Punch and loves Water Spout.
Mm.
Now, yeah, Origin Pulse, double in here, pretty safe from Farman's side.
Yeah, but at the same time, if switches into Among Us, I do think Ice Beam would do a lot more damage. Maybe be able to kill it from the Kyogre. Primal Kyogre? The Kangaskhan...
But if the Groudon stays in, that would be a disaster.
Yeah.
Ice Beam and Dragon Leap would not be enough to KO the Groudon.
Oh,
so
that's true.
He's
going
to need Pulse to be safe. So still going to do a ton of damage to Among Us if he switches in. And if it's anything else, well, that's just crazy. Xerneas is not going to enjoy taking two hits to the face.
Alright then, so Farm's just choice here is just to attack and hope that Origin Pulse hits here. Kenny has to make some tough decisions on what to switch out, even though he managed to break the Gengar lock. Losing the crest just means that he can only switch out one mon.
If his Kangaskhan is the slow variant, he's going to be forced to Sucker Punch to get off at least the last bit of damage before he goes down.
Yeah, and that actually will be information that Farman can pick up from his actions here, from Kenny's actions.
Kenny taking his time to work through his options.
Oh, okay, he does before the Groudon,
valuing the weather. And his last one is the Xerneas, who's
going
to be taking 2 hits. Well, Xerneas is not going to enjoy taking a plus 2 Dazzling Beam and the Orange Pulse in the rain.
Yeah, indeed.
Kangaskhan actually reveals Protect. So no freakout.
Is he trying to sacrifice his Xerneas, maybe?
Dazzling Beam does come out, plus 2 boosted onto Xerneas, who, without its own Geomancy boost, doesn't have that high attack defense stat, and will go down to the Water Spout distance. Farman not really caring about taking a Sucker Punch and losing his Water Spout damage.
But now that Kenny has got the weather back under his control, Kyogre is not to be firing off Water Spout or Ranger Pulse is...
But Kangaskhan is going to go down, likely.
But Groudon also resists the Fairy Step from Xerneas.
Kangaskhan is probably going to go down this turn.
Yeah, that is a foregone conclusion. Sucker Punch.
Since Farman is carrying the Water Spout, there's no
Ice Beam.
Of a quirky option like Pinion Bow Ground.
Or Ice Beam.
Or even the Shear Claw.
Yeah.
Ice Beam probably is third option, but Ice Beam... Well, Kangaskhan
protect again.
If he fails, Dazzling Beam will go into Kangaskhan. It's going to be enough to take it out in one hit.
It should be enough.
Kangaskhan
yes,
does go down, and Ice Beam into the Groudon might just be enough to slow him. Depending on how bulky, but I believe Kenny is running the Trick Room Groudon, so probably bulky enough to pick one Ice Beam.
Yes, it is. Managed to survive.
Blades goes onto both targets. Is it going to take a critical hit and kill either? The answer is no.
No. Oh, that's...
Farman with the speed advantage on both mons is going to be able to take game one.
Yeah, quite decisive on Farman's side.
The Gengar's... Oh, can you just forfeit it?
I would say the lead from Farman was what gave him an advantage to start rolling the momentum.
Even that being said, Kenny could easily have stopped it by going for the fake out. Oh, but he doesn't have fake out. It's a protect Kangas card. That's probably why he couldn't go for that play.
No, but if anything Melvin has taught me, it's possible for Kangas card to both have fake out and protect. Right. Yeah, but since Farman's opponent is not Melvin, I wonder if Farman picked up on that Kenny doesn't have the fake out and cannot deny that option.
Mm.
Yeah, so if it did, the fake out is not there.
Kenny did have it. They have the right plan in mind. It's obvious that he needed Trick Room up, so he led with the Cresselia, but Farman denied him. He couldn't stop that disruption, and the game just turned into a landslide with Farman having all the faster Pokemon.
Yeah, he did manage to turn the Groudon surviving.
That Precipice Blade missed on the Xerneas might have mattered a bit in the end.
Indeed. If the prior damage, but then
Kyogre
was
still... Kyogre would still have finished off the game. So.
Yeah. If the Precipice Blade hadn't crit
Kenny,
Kyogre.
Maybe Kenny would want to go for the Crobat Tailwind option this time.
Yeah, I actually believe that is stronger for him. Trick Room is not really a type of team that we have not seen.
And Crobat will at least get able to outspeed the Gengar on turn 1.
Yeah, and it provides Kenny with more offensive punch, I believe. The Super Fang for Crobat is actually very good to start getting KOs on Kenny's side.
So again, because Kenny lacks speed advantage, he doesn't get as many straightforward Super Fang and attack kills
and
as Farman.
And mentioned it, since Kenny's team is a bit on the slower side and the Groudon is a Trick Room variant, I believe, then Farman, if they both, assuming they both tailwind, Farman will still come out ahead because his mons are naturally faster than Kenny's.
So we are of course assuming that the Whimsicott, actually he does have tailwind. In fact, not just the Whimsicott, the Salamence has tailwind as well. When we fought, he actually tailwinded with both, which gave me quite a fright because I faked out neither.
Well, it's good information to know. So if he does meet the mens, that doesn't mean that he's...
No changes for Farman. Going with the Whimsy Guard lead that worked so well in Game 1. Has Kenny made the necessary adjustments?
No,
Kangaskhan and Cresselia once again. Is this where he reveals that he was carrying Fake Out all along?
Yeah, actually it's pretty smart because Kenny picked up on the fact that his mons are naturally slower. So the only way for him to win the speed is by using a Trick Room from Cresselia. And Farman also recognizes that, uses the same lead. Trying to pick up the one hit KO on Crest.
So again, now Kangaskhan Sucker Punch might come into play.
Ah, yeah, true. Very true. At this point, Farman might adjust. Maybe he goes for the Disable, but he can't really deny the
Trick Room. But again, the Cresselia will be locked in.
Exactly, and the Whimsicott can just encore it again to reverse the speed.
So again, he hasn't seen whether it's carrying the Mental Herb, so...
True. So,
in fact, he didn't see a Citrus, I believe. Oh no, he went down in one hit,
yeah,
so he went down.
One hit.
So the Mental Herb is still a possibility. Kenny has veered between different items on Cresselia through his entire career. Safety goggles, Mental Herb, Chestal Rest.
His option now is to hope for Mental Herb.
Yep, he needs a Mental Herb if he's going to get Trick Room up and keep it up. Farman taking his time to make his moves. Perhaps aware that Kenny is probably going to deny his Fake Tears Shadow Ball.
Yeah, at the same time, if the Gengar just... the ideal would be that the Gengar goes down to...
So no switch from Kenny again, so I would have to think Kenny is going for the Sucker Punch this time.
The question is whether Farman falls for it and loses his Mega Gengar for free.
Kangaskhan Mega evolves, so again, showing that he is definitely not scrappy. Or he's not carrying Fake Out, so it's irrelevant. So is he going to go for the Sucker Punch this time?
And...
Fake Tears comes out onto the Cresselia?
I believe Sucker Punch still...
Onto the Kangaskhan, but is Sucker Punch going to come out? Oh, no Sucker Punch! So... Double Edge into the Whimsicott, and Farman loses Whimsicott, and Cresselia is going to get Trick Room up unhindered. Farman perhaps overthinking this turn. Not getting anything done this turn at all, other than aspect minus 2 drop on the Kangaskhan.
Yeah, and now the Kangaskhan can still threaten the Sucker Punch on the Mega Gengar. Can he really meet... I would say a level 3 prediction, because he predicted that the Gengar would disable, so he didn't Sucker Punch instead.
Farman probably not bold enough to stick to his guns and go for the Fake Tears Shadow Ball play.
But begs the question, why did he Fake Tears the Kangaskhan?
That's a question only Farman can answer.
Yeah, I mean Kangsan is bulky, but since we saw the double H is...
I suppose Farman thinks that leaving Cresselia trapped is ideal since he can't really do anything. So again, are we going to see Sucker Punch coming out? Or even the Psychic from the Cresselia?
Sucker Punch does come out, it fails.
So skill swap, going to take the trap. So Kangaskhan and Cresselia now free to switch out.
Oh, but hey, Mega Gengar now has Levity.
And Mega Gengar does disable the Sucker Punch. But now Kangaskhan is probably going to switch out to reset the -2 special defense.
Yeah.
Though Cresselia probably not going to do much. So even though Kenny is able to switch now, he's still going to be taking a ton of free damage.
No, not if he switches in Groudon. Then he will deny
the Origin Pulse.
Yeah, the Water Spout. Although, if...
The Farman reads that, he can just maybe double dunk into the Cresselia with Ice Beam and Shadow Ball.
Yeah, at this point, I do believe Farman has identified that he's just going to leave the Crest alone and try to get rid of everything else on Kenny's team. Using Groudon to deny, yeah. But Farman, I would say his position is not good.
He does switch out the Kangaskhan with Sucker Punch disabled. Probably the Groudon. Groudon does come out to change the weather. Ooh, Desolate Land.
Position is not good for Farman.
Farman is gonna hope that he pressed a non-water attack.
Yeah. And we do have to remember that Chikrub is also up, thus the Groudon is faster than both Farman's mons at the moment.
So if he takes a double target Ice Beam and Shadow Ball, Groudon might not be sitting so pretty at the end of it. We shall see. Skill Swap goes onto the Groudon. Well,
maybe just to make sure Desolate Land.
But now Cresselia is forced to stay in. Because if Cresselia switches out, then Water Attack's alive again.
Oh, he wants the Groudon. Oh yeah, you're right.
That's very strange. Unnecessary play, in my opinion.
Yeah, he could have gone for attack.
Ice Beam and Sludge Bomb. Well, Sludge Bomb, not really what he wants to be using. Does he get a poison? Oh,
yes,
he gets the poison! But Groudon, I think, within range of taking... He will take 2 more turns of poison damage without issue. Yep. He will survive 1 more turn, so no double protect play available for Farman to take out the Groudon.
He can actually. He can double protect. Groudon will take 1 turn, oh yeah, but the Groudon will be able to fire off another attack.
Probably a helping hand boost the Breath of his Blades, which will wipe out both of Farman.
No. The important thing to note is that Mega Gengar now has Levitate.
You saw? Yeah. That is true.
Well, the Crest could switch.
And well, Eruption is not an option for Kenny right now, so...
Okay, if Crest now has Desolate Land,
if he switches out, then Origin Pulse is live.
Yes, exactly. And no, Origin Pulse is not live yet, but the Groudon kills the Mega Gengar, then...
Origin Pulse kills it.
Yeah, then Primordial Sea will be back on field. So, I don't know, Kenny's skill swap might be a double-edged sword here in this match, and he really needs to win this match to stay in this set of...
I wonder, actually, did he perhaps forget that he wasn't Levitate? Since I think giving Groudon Levity is always pretty
nice. Yeah, exactly.
Nice.
Yeah, I do believe he forgot. Maybe.
But again, Farman has no ground attack users, so who knows? Kenny possibly upgrading himself there.
Yeah, the skill swap was a bit unnecessary. It was awesome. It was
free damage for his Cresselia.
Yeah, exactly.
Onto the Gengar or even the Kyogre to guarantee the KO with Precipice Blade next
turn. Indeed.
And this poison could be what Farman needed to turn the game around.
Yeah, I did question why he should have gone for Shadow Ball instead, since fire resists the poison.
Shadow Ball might even have been enough damage to KO immediately. So, Farman being saved by the RNG.
Oh yeah, no. It was in the Kangaskhan slot. So if the Kangaskhan had...
Oh, he stayed in, yeah. Shadow Ball would have been a poor option. But Kangaskhan was always going to switch out.
Yeah. And -2...
Well, the poison saves Farman's play, so we're about to see what Kenny can come. Kenny does switch out the Groudon. Brett's predicting a double protect. Kangaskhan comes back
Kangaskhan
in.
As well.
Does Farman go for double protect? Kyogre does protect. Is Gengar going to go for protect as well? And Gengar does go for protect. Kenny reads the play well. Are we going to see yet another skill swap from Kenny? No, he goes for the Ice Beam this time. So, Ice Beam onto Kyogre's slot. I think it's fair to say that he has no other attacks if he's going for such a move. Probably the skill swap, Trick Room, Ice Beam, and Helping Hand.
Okay, but I mean, even the Ice Beam will have done enough damage. And at the same time now, Farman can easily just disable the Sucker Punch. Although if the Kangaskhan goes for the double H on the Kyogre, that'll be a different story. And Farman is still trapped, so he can't switch.
Gengar can switch out.
Hold on.
Gengar is ghost type.
No.
There's no more Shadow Tag.
Yeah, so actually Farman is able to switch out now, but does he realize that?
Does he really want to, is the question. Xerneas taking 3 damage. Helping Hand. I think the Helping Hand double H is coming onto the Cresselia this turn. I'm coming onto the Kyogre this time.
Oh, but Kyogre goes actually slower.
Ice Beam goes onto Kangaskhan, probably not enough KO. And Double Edge will come off with the Helping Hand boost. Should be enough to take down the Kyogre. yep, with one hit.
Yep,
it's not more even than enough.
I believe it should kill itself with recoil as well.
I don't think it'll do that much recoil. Oh, it does.
So now
Kyogre rather fat amount of HP.
So now the farm, yeah, goes for the Sludge Bomb instead.
Cresselia still packing a very healthy special defense there.
Oh, but now interestingly, Twist Trick Room has worn off.
Can he still does have the Mon advantage? And Farmer's about to reveal his last Pokemon. Probably the Xerneas?
Yeah, and...
Or even the... yeah, probably the Xerneas.
Kenny's Groudon isn't long for this world. Being poisoned...
He's gonna die to a Dazzling Gleam at this point.
Yeah. Red health, yeah.
And he's lost the Fake Out option as well. Or he probably never had Fake Out to begin with. So... Kenny's only chance is maybe having a Crobat tailwind to save him.
Actually, now
but
that
his last one is likely the Xerneas.
Now that Kangaskhan is gone... Mega Gengar is actually pretty free to sweep since the...
Mega Gengar doesn't exactly sweep. Is it sweep tends to get cut short, but...
It was checked by the Kangaskhan previously,
yeah, that's
but
true.
Now Kangaskhan
and
is
at this
gone.
Point, I believe Shadow Ball will KO the Cresselia. Actually, no, it won't.
It won't, but the Cress doesn't have the Psychic, so...
Xerneas comes out, and Farman reveals his own Xerneas as well. So...
Trick Room?
Kenny's only option, only chance is to Trick Room.
Protect Trick Room? Oh, but... Mega Gengar has a Sludge Bomb. Is it enough to kill the Xerneas?
No, it's not.
What about Sludge Bomb and the Dazzling Gleam?
Yes.
That could be the play that Farman goes
for. Of course, but the predictable play from Kenny here is to protect Xerneas and Trick Room. So Farman has to predict here. Kenny only has one option here. But Kenny being Kenny, he could read that his opponent expects that option. Oh, and he does go for the Protect, so did Farman read the Protect and double into the Cresselia slot. The whole match would hinge on Trick Room going up. Shadow Ball does come out onto the Cresselia. Farman reading Kenny's obvious play, and that could be curtains. Unless he has a Citrus Berry. No Citrus Berry.
Oh, but he goes for the
Geomancy. But I suppose with the boosted defense, he should be
special
able to take
defense.
Hits
yeah.
from both of ones. But Trick Room's going to go up, and Garden's going to be able to come in and sweep. Do I suppose Farman thinks he could stall out the Groudon by protecting.
Yeah, the Groudon is poison. Two turns of poison should be enough to take it out. So, yep, the Trick Room does go up.
Groudon cannot switch in because the obvious Dazzling Gleam is going to finish it off. Yet, Kenny really has no other option. Something's going to be sacked this time, probably the Cresselia.
Yeah, but at the same time, his Xerneas
is not able to one kill either. Probably not able to kill Gengar.
Yeah, because Gengar resists.
He probably needs to fish for the Moonblast on Gengar and pray for a special attack drop. Take less damage from the Sludge Bomb.
Well...
He's the only option right now.
Well, odds are in Farman's favor.
Or his Xerneas could go for a double protect.
I don't think that's ideal. I don't think that's ideal at all. Farman definitely odds stacked in Farman's favor because Sludge Bomb could poison the Xerneas as well, making his life a bit easier. Double protect on Xerneas. Actually, that's a pretty interesting option.
Yeah, I think he has to go for that option. It might be his only way out. Because if not, then he has nothing to stop the Groudon getting taken out when he comes back in. Or he could actually sack the Cresselia? No, he can't. He can't sack anything. Cresselia, in fact, Cresselia might be out. As in with Helping Hand.
Okay.
Oh, Helping Hand Dazzling Gleam.
Or Helping Hand Moonblast on the Gengar?
Oh, he does go for it. Helping Hand Moonblast onto the Gengar. Is it going onto the Xerneas?
What? That's
fishing for a special attack drop, perhaps. Nope. Sludge Bomb comes out onto the Xerneas. It's going to do a lot of damage. Perhaps getting a poison as well. Nope, no poison. Dazzling Gleam will finish off. Oh, hold on. Now both of Farmer's Pokemon are in Precipice Blaze kill range.
Yeah, but interestingly, Mega Gengar still has Levitate.
Oh.
Mega Gengar still has Levitate.
Oh dear. So the thing is, Farmer's Double Protect is obvious here.
Yeah, and he does have, Trick Room is still up, so Groudon does still have the advantage. But Mega Gengar still having the Levitate could be big. Could seal the game if Kenny has forgotten that Mega Gengar has Levitate.
Oh, yeah,
he remembers. So
Farman takes this set very cleanly. Two games to
Kenny skill swap coming back to haunt him in the end and not able to tie this set of matches. Farman, pretty convincing, I would say.
Again, my thing is that also pretty much in Farman's favor as well, because not only, even if he didn't have Levitate, he would have wanted to double protect, and the next turn he could double protect with both again.
And
only needed
one. Yeah,
just needed
because
one.
Of the poison.
Because of the poison. And of course, Pacific Blaze could miss. Because it's Pacific Blaze.
True, but we've not seen that yet this time. And we'll be moving on.
Farman goes to yet another Premier Challenge final.
Yeah.
Second of the new season. Or rather, first of the new season, but second overall this year.
And we'll be moving on to the next match
game.
Where Farman will be facing off against
Melvin. Surprise, surprise. No surprises here. Melvin runs the gauntlet and makes it into the top for beating two Zygards on the way. Beating Justin Zygarde in top 8 and beating Kid Zygarde in top 4.
I do feel that Zygarde coming into top 8 is an accomplishment in itself.
Alright, so we'll be taking a very brief break as we set up the final game.
Stay signing off.